here alone with a lover unlike no other. Sad to see a new horizon slowly coming into view. Yeah, I wanna be living for the love of you. Highest time, all that I'm giving is for the love of you. Touches me when the morning comes, feels good to me. Yeah, my love and me. Well, smoother than a gentle breeze, flowing through my mind with ease, soft as can be. It seems to me we could sail together in and out of mystery.
Came out pretty good, man. It wasn't too bad. It was
pretty good. I wanna be living for the love of you.
Sticky, real sticky.
All that I'm giving.
What's up, man? It's your man, Al Jihad the God, man. Black Power Crip Life. Those who know me know this. And this is a motherfucking... And I ain't gonna say Logan Smoke because I ain't got my original background for Logan Smoke. But this is where I'm finna get high and talk shit about the people who don't like Brother Kevin Samuels. Oklahoma City, stand up for old Kevin Samuels, man. I ain't know that brother from Oklahoma City, man. You know what I'm saying, man? So Oklahoma City, stand up for old Kevin Samuels, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of women, boy, they got a whole lot to say about that brother, man. Whole lot to say. They done called the nigga gay and some old shit, man. Me personally, I don't see fag in the nigga. I don't think the nigga's no booty lover. I'm thinking motherfuckers is just mad because that nigga hitting you with some 2021 Shahrazad Ali male version type shit. And a lot of women just don't want to, you know, don't like that dirty mirror, man. Don't like that dirty mirror, man. You got to look in that reflection, man. You know? Yeah. Getting myself right, man. Rolling up something real quick. I'm going to see if I can find this clip real quick. This thing we was talking about, they was trying to cancel Brother Kevin Samuels, man. Let me see if I can find this real quick. Let me see. Like, share, subscribe too, man. You know what I mean? Y'all motherfuckers, I'll be getting a nice little amount of views. What you motherfuckers is doing? Just looking at the motherfucker, then, hell, at least dislike the motherfucker. Something. Give me a thumbs down or something, motherfucker. Stop fucking just looking at the goddamn shit. And then, you know, that's it, motherfucker. Nah, I need you to like, share, and subscribe this shit, man. Stop fucking playing, man. Goddamn. Like, share, subscribe. Dislike, share. And then dislike it, then share it. And then tell people why you don't like my shit. Or something. Don't just stop doing that weird shit, niggas. Yeah, man. Let me see if I can find this about old Kevin Samuels. I know it's in there somewhere. No, I got it because I saved that shit. Because I was like, is niggas, like, not niggas, but women, like, are y'all serious? Like, y'all literally mad at this dude. Because everything he's in, like, every program I see, he don't say shit that's like where, like, motherfuckers, like, proving him, like, he lying or something like that. You know what I mean? He ain't saying, I mean, ain't nobody saying this man lying. They just saying, what, just how you said. Dude, like I say with the conscious community that's been talking to brothers killing brothers for years, man, no more soft talk, man. I mean, really, we so late in the game that we don't need no soft talk on anything. I'm talking about religion, politics, you know what I mean, women, men. It can't be no soft talk, man. It can't be no, you know what I'm saying, well, baby, if you do right, no, man, motherfucker, if you know that you's a trifling-ass hooker, then that's just what you is, man. It's just that you just seeing your own motherfucking dirty-ass motherfucking mirror, and you don't like that shit. Where the fuck is that goddamn picture at? Fucker, I can't find it, man. This is bullshit. Well, I guess I can speak on that. I'm still gonna speak on Kevin Samuels, but this popped up too with Simone Biles, Sha'Carri Richardson, and Naomi Osaka. All three of them sisters, from my understanding, not even in the Olympics. Like the three best, you know what I mean? Three of the best that come from, you know what I'm saying, from over here, you know what I mean? I think Osaka from over here, whatever. But look, they all sisters, all. Three beautiful sisters that's talented, beautiful, and the Billies don't want to let them, and little fish face motherfuckers over in Tokyo don't want to let these sisters compete, man. For what reason, I don't know. You know what I mean? Because I ain't just did the whole study on it. But I do know that they, all three of them, is not going to be in the Olympics. And they like the best thing going when it comes to the Olympics. You know what I mean? But I'm trying to find this. Just please hold up. I'm going to find it because I know I fucking saved this shit, man. I look like I'm crazy, like I didn't save this shit, but I know I saved this shit. Let me see, maybe I got it on my Instagram save. Let me check my Instagram real quick. I know I got this shit somewhere. But anyway, man, yeah, man, like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. Don't forget to do that, man. You know, I be trying to come with that old hard-ass content. This is my brother. He calling me right now, man. I'm going to call you back, bro. I'm going to call you back. I'm going to knock this out real quick. I'm going to get you, though. I'm going to call you back. This is fucked up. I can't find this shit, man. I really can't find it either. But anyway, you know, I wanted to show the little thing that I had seen on whatever one of these fucking sites or channels or whatever. Fucking apps. I don't know if it was my Facebook or my motherfuckers. I can't find it on the Facebook. I can't find it on this fucking Instagram. And I don't fuck with too many other shits. But anyway, so women are upset with Kevin Samuels because he basically, you know what I mean, like I said, putting that dirty mirror in your face, man. Then you always hear the same bullshit from a lot of women, man. Ain't no good man out there. Ain't no good man out there. And all that, man. That's not. Then I be saying, what's that little meme that no man can do all four? Don't cheat, don't blah, 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 blah. It's plenty of men that do that. It's just you. It's just they not doing it for you because evidently you ain't worthy of a nigga to hang up his player card. Because basically you probably ain't shit. So all the motherfuckers spent all this motherfucking time. My brother, he gonna keep on calling. Hold up for a second. Hold up. What's happening, bro?
Hey, I need to DK number, huh?
Yeah.
Know why?
You say you need DK's number?
Remember, I was telling you about I wanted somebody to take pictures at this party.
Yep, you did say that, and I totally forgot. I ain't gonna lie, totally forgot about
Come
it.
On, I forgot too. I said, let me call bro and get his number, man.
I'm text it to you right now. Actually, I'm actually doing a podcast right now.
Oh, okay, my bad, bro.
No, you're good. You're actually on it right now because I got you on speaker.
All right, what's up, bro? Yeah, Scrapino, man.
Yeah, that's right. All right, as soon as I finish it, which is like in the next, 10-20 minutes, I'll be finishing. I'll text it to you.
Don't forget, man.
I promise you I won't. You got my word.
All right.
No man can do all four. Be faithful, stay home. And then I be seeing some of the shit y'all want nigga to be faithful. Stay home. I can't find that shit. But I'm saying them motherfuckers talking about stay home. Like, nigga, what kind of man you want? A lot of you women don't want men. Because when you get a man, all that old hood rat shit you be doing out there in them streets, all that old, you know, posting for the gram and all that, ain't no real man a real man. I ain't talking about a nigga that got a lot of money or some old shit like that's gonna trick on your punk ass. I'm talking about a man that is a protector and a provider for his family. You know what I mean? That is a teacher to his whole entire family. One that actually, Hold up. I know it. Now, I did see this on Facebook. I pray I can find this shit, because the sister said some more dumb ass shit. I hope I can find this. Man, let me see. I know I probably got this one. Hold up. Hold up. One second. I think I got a little bit. Hold up. I'm trying to have a lot of dead time on this motherfucker, man. But listen, I can't find shit now. That's fucked up. Let me put this shit in another. Anyway, one sister, she was on there talking about, Goddamn, what the fuck is that shit? That's some bullshit, cuz. Men just wanna lay in your house. Hold up. Men just wanna lay in your house, use your shit, blah, blah, blah. For one, why your dumb ass letting a grown ass man move in the house with you? You stupid motherfucker. If you looking for a man, a protector and a provider, should you be moving in with that nigga? If the nigga wanna be with you. If you really wanna be with you, he'll get his shit together and move you in with him. You know what I mean? I'm gonna put you out of my business a little bit. There was a time me and my wife, we had got to a big old argument. You know what I mean? And we had split up, you know what I mean, for a while. It wasn't a long, long while, but it was a while. Hold on one second. God damn, I thought I had it. That's not it either. Shit, man. This is some bullshit. But yeah, goddamn, son, what was I saying? I lost my train of thought that day, goddamn quick. I'm trying to find this damn thing, and I can't find it. I can't remember what the hell I was saying. Goddamn. But anyway, to the original topic, of course, it's about Kevin Samuels. Can't no man do all this, do all that. For one, that's what I was talking about. Me and my wife had split up. Like, me and my wife, we had a nice house on the east side, you know what I mean? Like I said, I'm gonna put y'all in our business a little bit. We had a big old major fallout, so we lost our house, and, you know, we went our separate ways and whatnot. But even when I went my separate way, I didn't go like a lot of motherfuckers I do know. I didn't get into it then go find a woman to go lay up under, my nigga. You know what I mean? Like, and then, well, I went and got my own shit. You know what I mean? In my name, my shit, I went and got my, it was a little punk ass apartment, but it was mine. I wasn't finna go live up under no motherfucking woman. That's just not how I get out, pimp. So, and I'm not gonna be driving, living in a woman's house and driving a goddamn car. No, I have my own shit. And this is every time, you know what I'm saying? Every time I have my own shit, I have my own, every house I had, my name was on that motherfucker. You know what I mean? It's mine. You know what I mean? It wasn't me living off a goddamn thing. You know what I mean? So when me and my wife, of course, you know how that shit go, got to a big ass argument. So, you know, it's time to make up, blah, 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 all that. I didn't have to go run and to go live with her. It's when we got back together, I instantly took back. You know what I'm saying? And I forgot to say, like when we went our separate ways, I wasn't paid first month in a deposit, so her and my babies can have a place to stay. You know, like I said, the big split up, because this is on us for doing dumb shit, for getting into it. So we did the split up. I made sure that they had a place to stay. That means I wouldn't pay for their first month rent, so wouldn't know the deposit, all of those shit. I paid for that, moved them in, and, you know, they had a place to stay. I was still just kind of on some drifter shit, you know what I mean, until I found my own place. But I made sure they were straight first. You know what I mean? That's what men do. You know what I mean? That's what grown-ass men do. You know what I mean? So, I would also say that women who say that there's no man, no good man out here, you're lying. You see them every day, all the time. You know what I mean? You see them dressed in all black at them all black gun clubs. You see them marching up and down for when Sister Breonna Taylor got murdered by them punk ass pigs. You seen them in Stone Mountain, Georgia. You know what I mean? When they were strapped up, ready to ride against the punk ass KKK. So And you seen the brothers out there with the suit and bow ties on, or you see the brother out there with the African garments on out there, you know what I mean, selling incense and whatnot. So you see good men out there. Because a lot of the brothers I'm naming off, I'm talking about brothers that's in the 5% Nation of Islam. You know what I mean? I don't know too much about how the Israelite brothers get down, but just they discipline alone speaks volumes. You know what I'm saying? They discipline alone speaks volumes. You know what I mean? So I'm going to say the Israelite brothers, the Nation brothers, brothers that's in these gun clubs, the Black Panther Party brothers, you know what I mean? It's brothers out there, but y'all look at those brothers like, I ain't messing with that old black power and shit out there. And that's why your dumb ass got all them babies and you're by yourself. And you get a good chance your punk ass is going to die by yourself, because only thing you think about is sex and how to get over on a nigga to get some money. That's majority of you motherfucking women out here. So you can't say there's no good man out there, because I'm a product of being a good man. I'm a provider, I'm a protector, and I'm a teacher. You know what I mean? My wife ain't got no dumbass husband, man. My children don't got no dumbass motherfucking father. And I go hard for my family. You know what I mean? So, and that's even on bad terms. Even on bad terms, my wife, that's still the mother of my children. So even on bad terms, we get into it, still, that's still the mother of my children. Meaning I'ma love her forever. Forever. It don't matter when we get into it, if we stay together, if we not together, whatever, that is still the mother of my children. She is the gateway to creating baby gods. So I'm going to treat her as such. That is a queen. So I'm going to treat her as such, good or bad terms. I'm not talking about fucking that go through all type of bullshit. And be like, I'm going to kill you and all that over there. I don't do all that bullshit, man. You know what I mean? Because nothing is meant to be forever. Nothing. I don't give a fuck what the fuck it is. Nothing. Only thing that's guaranteed in this motherfucking world is death, nigga. That's the only thing that's guaranteed around this bitch. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man. Yeah, but I just want to get on there, man, and spit that out real quick, man, because like I said, I'm saying y'all shouldn't listen to Kevin Samuels and this and that. Why not? Why not? Anything he's saying, is it a lie? When he talked to that motherfucking broad, Jasmine Blue, what the fuck ever, he made her look like the dumb motherfucker she is. And the rest of the motherfuckers get on there and try to, well, I understand what you say. And I'll be seeing all of those shit. You know what I mean? Just the body language and, you know, man, you getting pissed off. You know what I mean? I can't just name certain episodes because, like I said, my silly ass didn't keep a lot of shit saved. But I'm just saying, though, man, the most of the videos I see on that brother when he be talking to them sisters, man, it be the same shit. It's just like you getting mad because he's telling you the truth. You know what I mean? And then, you know what I mean? Then, let's just keep it 100. Today's females don't like alpha males. Because the black man has been so feminized and so punctified lately that when y'all see a real ass line and y'all miss, y'all don't even know how to handle that shit. You know what I mean? I ain't talking about a nigga that's coming in, beating your ass, and then barking commands. No, I'm talking about a genuine lion. Meaning that a lion is a motherfucker that know what the fuck is going on in life, knowing what he wants for his family, finna execute whatever plan he got to make sure his family is straight. And if the lioness or the woman he's with or whatever, you're going to follow. You're going to follow. Now, when I say follow, that don't mean, like I said, it don't mean like you just my personal slave or nothing. No, your woman is there to give you balance. So if you come up with a decision and if she sees something wrong in that decision, she's supposed to bring balance in it. The decision is still up to the king, but still the queen brings balance in a lot of the life decisions. You know what I mean? That's my eye. You know what I mean? That's the, so she's bringing balance. But if you got a brother that's a king, that's an alpha, like myself, that's, you know what I mean, that's taking care of what I need to take care of and all that, and I'm not beating your ass, I'm not calling you bitches and hoes and all that. When I tell you to do something, when I ask you to, I know, boy, women to get on some bowl. What you mean, tell? Okay, when I ask my wife to do something and it's not going against her morals as a black woman, you know what I'm saying? It shouldn't be not even just my wife, just any woman in general. It shouldn't be no going back and forth. Not when you got a God. Not when you got a king. Now, you can do that shit with niggas all day. You know what I mean? You walk in the house, you been at work all day, this nigga laying on the couch, farting and shit, socks and shit. You know how your socks be half-assed off your feet and hanging over and shit? And you know, you look up, you walk in, he talking about, let me borrow $5 and let me get your keys to your car. See, but a lot of you women like niggas like that. A lot of you women don't want no men. A lot of you niggas want your sons that you fucking. A lot of you niggas want sons that you fucking on. That's what a lot of women want. Old beta ass niggas that, baby, I'll care for you. All that old type shit. I know y'all seen that meme with, when it was Jaheim. It was Jaheim on one side and Too Short on the other side. Jaheim was like damn near 10 years younger than Too Short, talking about better put that woman first. And this nigga looking, but now I'm talking about, he got the whole gray bird, that nigga fucking got the whole rooftop shit coming way back here. And Too Short over there looking like $1 million. They like, man, shit, man, fuck these bitches, man. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. Now I know y'all be like, how's you black power and blah, blah, blah? You calling black women bitches. Because stop playing. You have queens and goddesses, and you have bitches, my nigga. Those are not nouns. Those are action words. Those are verbs. To be a goddess, you have to act like a goddess. You got to walk, talk like a goddess. Queen, walk, talk like a queen. If you a bitch or a whore, and you walking, talking like, and acting like one, nigga, that's what the fuck you are. You think just because you black, I'm supposed to just instantly just look at you and be like, just instantly just, oh, queen of the earth, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Now, far as your DNA, in your royal bloodline, yes. That's just, I mean, if it just come down to it, far as on a physical aspect of it, yes, the black woman is God. The black man is God. True indeed. But bottom line, nigga, those are actions, action words. Those are not fucking nouns. Being called a goddess is not a noun. That's not a name. That's a title. Being called a god is a title. Being called a goddess is a title. A queen is a title. A bitch is a title. A hood rat is a title. Because a motherfucker wouldn't call your ass that shit if you didn't act, walk, talk, and do the same shit. Do that shit. You twerking all the shit on Instagram. Like, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to let y'all women know something. Y'all women, a lot of women that's on there doing for twerking, being half naked on Facebook and Instagram and all of those shit. My nigga, just like Brother Kevin Samuels will probably say, it's a good chance you're going to die alone, my nigga. That beauty fades out, my nigga. This is a thing called age. You're growing up. When you grow up, you know what I'm saying? When you're growing up, you know what I'm saying? Your body don't stay. I mean, well, yes, luckily, I mean, I'm going to say in a very blessed way, a lot of black don't crack. But when you got these bras putting on 100 pounds of makeup, eyelashes that's doing like this over their eyes and shit, yeah, that fingernail. Like I said, I still don't see with a woman with fingernails this goddamn long. I still feel in my heart that y'all not clean. Y'all can't wipe y'all ass or y'all little cootie pappies doing that. Because how many, if you got the, now this is the roll of toilet paper and your nails is way up here. So you gotta grab the toilet paper, flap it around you, and I'm just trying to see how y'all do it, man. You know what I mean? And I know when y'all wipe y'all ass and y'all boo-boo, y'all be getting boo-boo up under them nails and shit. You ain't gonna tell nobody, but I know you do, little nasty asses. So, I'm just saying, man. You wanna be a queen? You wanna be a goddess? You wanna be treated like a goddess? You wanna be treated like a queen? Motherfucker, act like one. But if you act like a bitch, if you act like, you know what I'm saying, some little thot motherfucker, some shit that nigga can run through real quick. And I'm letting you know, when they see you on Instagram, shit like that, booty popping, shit like that, my nigga, what man, for one, like, let's say I was a single dude, and I see a sister on there, booty popping or something like that. Me, I'm saying, like I said, man, like I said, it's the difference between a boy and a man. A man would never put no baby in some shit like that. Because men is looking to make families. A man is would want to make babies and make families because we want to leave behind a legacy. Now, little boys just want to just, you know what I'm saying, fuck y'all in your mouth and you know, all that old type shit. You know what I'm saying? You know, whatever, right? But a man and a boy will marry you. I mean, hell, look at Cardi B and Offset. Yeah, so, you know, idiots. I mean, idiots can come together. What you mean, idiot? Nigga, at least they got more money than you. That's what y'all go, I mean, that's what the average dumb nigga say. Nigga that's living in the Matrix. Stupid motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, but that's just my little take on it. Like I said, I'm riding with you, Kevin. If there's a small chance you happen to see this video, brother, I'm riding with you, man. Oklahoma City nigga too, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm riding with you, man. You know what I mean? And all that old talking about the nigga fruit booty and all that. Man, I don't see fag in that nigga. I just see a smooth ass brother that got some knowledge of self and be dropping that motherfucking wisdom when it comes to how to respect your man. Cause like I said though, a lot of you women don't want no men. It's millions of good men out here. Millions. That'll do that whole all four thing you're talking about, faithful, provider, blah, blah, all of those shit, come home and I don't cheat and all of those shit. It's millions of us. But you're not in that crowd because you too busy in the dumb crowd popping your ass for Molly's and finna go suck old the nigga dick in the bathroom and all that old type shit in the clubs and shit. You know what I'm saying? So, no. Why would a nigga wife you up? Why? My nigga, listen, cuz, if you on Facebook twerking, Instagram twerking, all that old shit, no one is going to wife you, my nigga. Not no man. You can get a lot of niggas and boys, they'll wipe, and a few crackers, you know, the crackers talking about the white boy's son and all that old type shit. So, you might can go over there and find what you're going to go through, but I can guarantee you finna go through hell, because just when two dum-dums connect, it's just dumb shit, and they make more dumb babies. You know what I mean? You got this nigga with the skinny jeans on, designer shit, big chains, old dreads, and, you know, and then he got his main little thing over his bitch wearing shit that she might as well just walk out naked outside. These two dumb motherfuckers have a baby. You know what I mean? But they got money though. They pushing Jags and Benz and shit. You know what I mean? They do up there. They popping Molly's, doing coke. You know what I mean? And they have some more dumb babies. And then they, you know what I'm saying, they do shit like Juvenile. I guess well, I ain't gonna say the nigga was broke, but I know they get a nigga bag to do that vax that thing up video. That's with some of the dumbest shit in the motherfucking world, homie. You know what I mean? Dumbest shit in the world, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Dumbest ass video in the world. You know what I mean? You know, I'm just saying, it'd be niggas like that, you know what I mean? Then it'd be a nigga on some Juvenile shit. You know what I mean? You don't like, I'm saying, like a rap industry basketball nigga or whatever. You know what I mean? I'm just saying goofball nigga that like to pop bottles and shit like that. They fuck this bitch that got the fake booty, fake her, and then like Shahrazad Ali said, broad will be like, I want a real man. And Shahrazad Ali said, what for? Well, I mean, what for? You know what I'm saying? You got on fake wig, fake eyelashes, fake nails, fake ass, fake, but you want a real man. You get your gump ass body with this bullshit, man. Dude, like motherfuckers like Cardi B and Nicki Minaj and shit like that. I'm just naming, cause you know these is the, you know what I'm saying, bras that a lot of you dumb bras look up to. You know what I'm saying? I can dig it. Megan Thee Stallion shit. Like, I wouldn't let motherfuckers like that even watch my daughter, my nigga. I wouldn't let motherfuckers like them even babysit my daughter, my nigga. Like, I wouldn't. And so, damn sure wouldn't be wanting to put no babies up in no motherfucker like that, man. Nah, hell nah. I'm gonna keep it all we want. My nigga, I'm at the point, I guess the point of my life right now, if I was a single nigga, I still would be down there like on some virgin shit, nigga. And I'm not even bullshit. Because a nigga don't want to go like, you know, like, you know what I'm saying, go out and seeing those old big booty motherfuckers and then whatever, and then go knock them down with a condom bust. All right, now you got a disease or unwanted baby by a dumb motherfucker. You know what I mean? Or the whole pull out early shit. And that's what I heard now, as far as when it comes to motherfuckers now. Back in my day, you know, in the 90s and shit like that, you know what I mean? When I was 15, 16, nigga, we strapped up, nigga. We was wearing condoms, nigga. 18, 19, we wearing condoms. Now these motherfuckers talking about pull out game. My pull out game strong. My pull out game was weak, cuz. Pull out game. Nigga, why is you would have to pull out, you strap up. Well, like I said, I don't know now. I gotta take that back. Cause I just said that I wouldn't even be going around fucking no motherfuckers with condoms. I mean, that's just me. I'm just saying because, like, I look at it like this. When a nigga know his worth, I'm speaking like that with me. I don't know about other niggas. When I know my worth, I know I'm a man. I know I hold my family down. It's not even a, you know what I mean? It ain't none of that, baby, let me borrow your car, baby, let me. No. I hold this motherfucker down. I hold my household down, my nigga. Household. I hold this down. Me. You know what I'm saying? Of course, with the help of my queen, like I said, that's where balance come in at. But I'm saying, far as financially, spiritually, I'm the teacher, man. Yeah, that's why my little babies are little geniuses, because they got a genius for a daddy. Thank you very much. But anyway, I'm just rambling. Like I said, I heard that bullshit with Kevin. I mean, I seen that bullshit with Kevin Samuels, man, and all these sisters attacking his brother. Talking about, and his sister, well, and awesome niggas too.
Y'all shouldn't let him degrade the sisters.
Nigga, the sisters be degrading they self, cuz. I'm in the streets, so I see that shit, my nigga. I see when I be out in traffic or whatever, I see what, you know what I mean? So, a lot of these women just like, I mean, put like this. I'm gonna give you a story real quick and I'm off in the end of this shit. I was with my cousin Tiny. And I ain't gonna say, ooh, this is when I first got out a while ago. And my mans was getting into it with we used to call them back in the day gangbang groupies. And this certain gangbang groupie spit on this nigga. Cause at first I was like trying to like back up, like, hey man, don't do this, don't do that, don't, you know, man, calm down, man, don't do that. You know what I mean? But this girl like literally like, and pff, nigga, I bagged up like, pff, I can't even save you from that one. Like, why would you even do it? You know this is a man.
Like that nigga said on South Central, this is a man, Buddha. Do you not see this is a man standing behind you, Buddha?
That girl spit on that dude. I'm talking about that nigga hit it with a nice three piece. Boom, bye, boom. And I don't even condone on Nutty Block Crip. I don't condone him beating on women. I ain't never hit my wife. I ain't never called my wife a bitch, a hoe. I ain't never put my hands on her. None of that shit. Never. Ever. Never. You know what I mean? So, I'm just saying, so I don't condone the shit, but my nigga. Oh, man. My nigga went all the way. And I didn't do nothing. I put my hands up. I'm like, shh. Man, you brought that on yourself. You gotta handle that. You brought that on yourself. You know what I'm saying? There's a few more other situations. I Damn. I'm over stuttering and shit. I'm trying to think of the God damn it. I said, think of the homie name. The homie Schizo.
I ain't gonna, you know what I'm saying? I'm naming the names, but I ain't gonna just name, you know what I'm saying, the whole situation where everybody, you know what I mean? Because I ain't put my man's business out there. But it was, I guess I am a little bit, but I'm doing it in a very joking manner. Yeah, you know I mean? Because I'm saying, like, I seen these dudes, like, basically I'm saying, because I seen dudes that try to hold their temper. I see dudes that try to hold their temper, and like, I seen a sister, I'm talking about get all of my man's face, like, was, I mean, and my man's was like driving, was trying to come. I seen this dude, like, man, my man's in the car, man, just shut the fuck up. And she all in the, that nigga hit the brakes. cuz did his thing. But, like, I'm saying, cuz, like, come on, man, it's, like, this gender reversal shit, no, man. Like, that's why niggas like Kevin Samuels is needed. You motherfuckers need that mirror in your face, man, so you can see the ugly reflection of yours, man. See my big ass son back there? Big. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm just saying. And see, that's one thing by my sons, though. Boy, I'm going to teach them every dirty, slimy trick in the book when it comes to these motherfucking punk ass, fake ass bras, man. Yeah, my baby's going to be cold. And my daughter, oh, man. Oh. Like, my oldest daughter, I ain't let her go to the prom, cuz. And I know y'all probably look like, let her get her dressed up and then. No nigga finna fuck my daughter that night, nigga. Bottom line, that's what I told her. I trapped her like, no, you can't go to the prom. She wasn't really just too much into it anyways. Like, she wasn't just like, you know what I mean? But I could tell she was a little bit disappointed, but not really. I hope she wasn't. That's just the father of me talking. That's the father in me talking. So, but yeah, my daughter, I said, no, you can't go to the prom. Even if she wanted to go, I wasn't going to let her go. I mean, whatever. Fuck your American standards, nigga. No, nigga, my daughter's not finna go with some little young nigga. This nigga that been taking shots of him and all that. Nigga, I was 15 to 16 years old. And, nigga, I was fucking like a porn star at 15 to 16. So I got daughters that, there's no way. Nah, nigga, not that one. Not today. Not today, nigga. And my baby girl, if she's the baby of all my babies, she's the baby, and she's a girl too. No, I'm a teacher. She's gonna be an example of what a queen is. She's gonna be an example of what a goddess is. You know what I mean? But even my soldiers, my boys, they gonna be examples of what good men should be. I'm gonna make sure of that. You know what I mean? But yeah, I'm just rambling. You know what I mean? I just seen this shit on Kevin Samuels, kinda got pissed off a little bit. Not pissed off, but like, man, sit y'all miserable. And they usually come, I'm gonna say this, I'm gonna get up out of here. Most of the time when I usually hear a lot of shit, miserable shit that women be saying, like, it usually be the motherfucking women that be like in their late 30s, late 30s on up, you know, the more miserable, done been ran through by the homies back in the 90s. Now you mad, looking at your daughter with an attitude towards her. Cause you all saggy titted. You know what I'm saying? motherfucking Cooter Pappy looking like flaps on a fucking truck. So now nobody wants you no more. You did that to yourself, cuz. It was plenty of good men out here. You wanted the thugs and the ones that popped gallons and y'all be saying bitch every other word. That's what you wanted. So you got it. So now you got a gang of unwanted babies by niggas that don't even come through and take care of them. You know what I mean? So yeah, man. So stop trying to be, because a lot of women today is overly sexual right now, man.
They over-sexual right now. They want to fuck, buddies. All talking about how good their pussy is, how good their pussy is, and all that old shit. How good this is, how good that is. And how make this nigga give me some money, how am I gonna get... But, nigga, don't y'all know y'all practicing prostitution? That's just because you ain't on the corner, on the motherfucking internet, you know what I mean, doing your shit. Nigga, you're still a form of prostitution. I'm gonna get... Fly some motherfucker for this nigga tonight, cause he finna pay for all my shit. Blah, 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 blah. I'm stuck on this nigga dick. That bitch, I'm trying to get pregnant by this nigga. You know how y'all be talking, cuz. And then y'all come right back around.
It ain't no good man around here. It's no good man here. Nowhere.
Yeah, it is. There's plenty of them. You just don't want to be with her because you don't want to change your dirty ass ways, my nigga. See, when you fuck with a man, I'm talking to all the ladies. When you fuck with a man and you still act like a child, either you going to grow the fuck up, you going to get the fuck out. Because a nigga don't want to build no relationship with no dumb ass motherfucker. A relationship as well as a family. Don't nobody want to build no family with no retarded, stupid ass motherfucker. Why? Because when I die, who the fuck gonna raise my babies right? Because if you're already a dumb motherfucker, then why would I put a baby in you? Vice versa. Women. I'm talking to the fellas now. Women. If this nigga ain't produced not a goddamn thing, cuz, why? Like, why would you be like, baby, you come move in my apartment? You come live with me, baby. You know, because nigga gave you a few dollars when y'all first met, fucked your brains out, y'all pops and bollies and stuff, so now you gonna let cuz move in with you. Now he done beating your ass and drinking your baby's juicy juice and all type of shit. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just saying, cuz, that's my whole thing, cuz. Like, stop getting mad at Kevin Samuels for telling you motherfuckers the truth. Nigga, God, goddesses, king, queen are not nouns. Niggas and niggas. God, goddesses, king, queen, are verbs. Verbs. Meaning they're action. You gotta put that shit in motion, my nigga. But no, don't ever think a motherfucker, not no man. See, a lot of you motherfuckers be getting, a lot of motherfuckers don't know what a man is. A provider. A protector. He's a pastor. A man's supposed to be damn near, any question, anything need to be handled in that house, that man's supposed to be doing whatever he can to make sure that family's straight. And I don't know if I finished telling the story, but yeah, when me and my wife got back together, yeah, I went and got us a place to stay and moved her in with me. Yeah, that's how that went down. Yeah. Did that a couple times.
We've been together since 06, though. And then we get into it.
She gonna be mad no motherfuckers. But yeah, y'all be, we've been together since 06. We done been on some on and off shit, y'all be. But we finally got married in 2012, and that's what solidified it. Y'all be with the baby. Well, the babies that solidified it. Fuck that Peckerwoods wedding certificate and all of those bullshit. Nah, that shit got solidified when we started having them babies together. You know what I mean? Even before that, because I had my daughter, she had her son, and you know, we started our family off just like that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man. So yeah, if you want a real man, women, stop going for bums. If you, I'm gonna make some niggas mad. I know. But I love black women, cuz. I love even the dumb motherfuckers, man, because when you know the essence of a black woman, when you know what she truly has the capability of being, you just look at her like, damn, sis. you can do this, this. And I ain't talking about, when I say damn sis, I don't mean damn sis like your body and nothing like that. I'm just looking at you like, damn sis, like, you beautiful. Only thing you need is a motherfucking brain. But then on top of that, like I said, even the niggas that y'all deal with, y'all, a lot of y'all go get idiots. Y'all go get niggas that can't feed, they can fuck you all day, but they cannot feed your mind, man. And I don't know if y'all noticed or not, but that's where the real stimulation come from. You know what I mean? When that dopamine get released, especially off when it's not only sexual but intellectual too, y'all missing out, man. 100, y'all missing out. So sisters, look for the guys that wear these colors all the time. You say you want a real man, right? You say you want a real man. But you know, when you find a man that wear these colors a lot, that the club hopping shit that you used to do, that shit is out. We building families, we building revolutions. I mean, I'm not building revolution, but we building families, and that's part of the revolution. And that's building up the black family. So we believe in being fathers. Black men. Don't say that there ain't no good women out here, bullshit. But when you find a sister, a beautiful, beautiful sister that's spiritually ready, I mean, her intellect is phenomenal. I'm talking about when you talk to her, it's like, you know what I mean? She's speaking ideals. She's speaking life into you. When you get one like that, no, all that old, being that, hey, what's up with the baby girl? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's not, she's not fucking with you, my nigga. She gonna look at you like a lost cause, my nigga. She gonna look at you like, why would I bury this man's babies when he gonna make my sons or my daughter fucking idiots because he's a fucking idiot? You know what I mean? Kevin Sanders, I fuck with you, nigga. Why I got this? I thought I had my joint in my damn hand, boy. It's goddamn weed, nigga. But yeah, guys. Kevin Samuels, I fuck with you. Your Oklahoma brother fuck with you, man. You know what I'm saying? Oklahoma City, to be exact, baby, 405. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I'm fucking with you, man. You know what I'm saying? And Sister Shaharazad, I pray that you see this too, you beautiful sister. That's Mama Shaharazad. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just saying, that's Mama Shaharazad. And sister, if you happen to ever see this, I just want to let you know that I love you for life. Like, hearing you speak, and I ain't even talking about even on the women or the men. I'm talking when y'all hear you speak just on the intellectual level of history. Woman, I love you. You are like, I look at you as my mother type, auntie, mother, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's another sister, Sister Ava Muhammad, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? Like, these sisters here, like, a lot of you gangbanging niggas, a lot of you so-called street niggas, these women are beautiful, but these sisters are older sisters, but I'm going to say it's sisters that's younger than them, that has that type of mindset, you niggas wouldn't even know what to say to them. If they get to talking about shit, I mean, just simple. Let's just say that they want to say like, well, baby, what do you think about Kemet? Or some shit like that. Your dumb ass gonna look like, Kemet? Man, I don't know about no Kermit. You know what I'm saying? But you women lay down with niggas that they can only speak on sports. They can only speak on entertainment. They can only speak on bullshit. And you niggas, and you women lay down and open your little funk ass little twats to some shit like that. Have babies by motherfucking morons. And then my niggas, you fucking lay down, put your little stinking ass dick in this little stupid ass little girl that's dumb as a motherfucker that don't know shit. Like, and I'm telling you, this is what I know for 100% fact. It's a few motherfuckers on there that when I was in them streets heavy, I mean, they be on Facebook, Instagram. I'm talking about niggas look like models. Motherfucker done been to a few households, man. And Yeah, my nigga. I'm talking about clothes everywhere. You know what I mean? You on Instagram and Facebook looking like motherfucker, and your whole nigga, I'm talking about, nigga, you walking in motherfucker, nigga, like, why you got a, so you got one recliner in the middle of the floor, you know what I'm saying? Got the blow up mattress in the back with the clothes scattered everywhere with little Ray Ray and them running around the house, saggy, shitty diapers and, you know, and shit like that. And then this motherfucker had the audacity to lay down and have another baby. Nigga, please. Kevin Samuels, I'm rocking with you, cuz. Oklahoma City, stand up, man. Sister Shahrazad Ali. I gotta get humble when I speak of you. Sister Shahrazad, your book, your lectures, beautiful. So anybody who's listening to this right now, go look. If you're not hipped on Kevin Samuels, go to Kevin Samuels' page and like, share, subscribe. Like you like and share, subscribe this motherfucker too, man. Goddamn, I'm getting tired of telling you niggas that, man. Like, share, subscribe this motherfucker, man. Like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe, nigga. Don't just look at the motherfucking video, motherfucker. Like, share, subscribe. You know what I mean? Anyway. Kevin, Black Power, brother. Black Power. Mama Shahrazad, assalamu alaikum, dear sister. I love you, and I pray to hear your beautiful voice for many years to come. Kevin Sandy, keep doing your motherfucking thing, nigga. Anyway, cuz, I'm cloudy, man. It's your man, Al Jihad the God, man. Like, share, subscribe, man. You know what I mean? You know, support the channel, man. Thanks for the Cash App, though. Thanks for the, you know, the subscribers, you know what I mean, and the likes that I've been getting, man, you know what I mean, we gonna keep doing this thing, man, you know, for those who rocking with me, man, you know, we gonna keep this shit going, man, we gonna keep this shit going, man, you know, it's another sister, too, check her out, I think it's up on the Love Dorsey, that's another sister, homie. Like, a lot of you sisters, y'all take these names down. I'm gonna get off this motherfucker. Sisters, take these names down so you can find you a man that's gonna treat your motherfucking ass with respect. But it's gonna take your punk ass to come out them motherfucking streets, off that thot hood shit, and come up to your godhood. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna take these names down, nigga. Shahrazad Ali. Love Dorsey. Ava Muhammad. Mother Tynetta. Shit. I got some more, man. I gotta help you niggas out, man. Erica Lachey. That's another sister. Beautiful sister. Go to Fly Nubian Queen on YouTube. All them sisters is beautiful on there. Like, when I say beautiful, I mean they spirit. You know what I mean? The stuff that comes out their mouth. The physical, of course, they black. They're beautiful, of course. But I'm saying what's in them, what's coming out their mouth is... Man, sisters is something else. Something else, man. Beautiful sisters. So anyway, like, share, subscribe, cuz. You know what I mean? This is your man, Al Jihad the God, Black Power, Crip Life. Those who know me know this. Oh, what?